my name is Anna Amilon, and I'm a senior researcher at the Danish National Center for Social Research. And I do evaluation, policy evaluation, in particular in the fields of late life, old age, labour market. My institute also does work in family, social care, education, and so on.
And how would you explain what you do to a layperson?
Well, that's difficult, but at present I'm working on a project that's about population ageing and how we can deal with that, both as a challenge but also as an opportunity, because as older people also constitute a resource in the sense that they're volunteering, they're helping their relatives, family members, but then again they also of course are a cost to society in the sense that they need care, so we also try to find solutions for optimizing care.
What would you say are currently the three main policy priorities for long-term care in Denmark?
Well, priorities is sort of difficult to say, but if you look at the political discourse, I think the main topics at present are about, first of all, we're going to lack staff in the long-term care sector. A lot of people that work in the care sector are retiring now, so within just 5 to 10 years, we're going to have a massive lack of staff. So that's a problem that's being discussed quite a lot at present. Another topic relates to how to treat people with dignity, how to give older people choice, an opportunity to sort of have control over their lives. That's also another topic. And then I think a third topic is about cool technology on the one hand and warm hands on the other, sort of this trade-off between staff and technology and how you can sort of optimize and not only seeing technology as a bad, because I think that's been at least the previous discourse, and I think we're moving towards seeing technology more as an opportunity.
And to what extent do you think these priorities have changed in the last 5 years, if they've changed at all?
Well, I think 5 years ago, I think the discussion was more about rehabilitation, because in Denmark there's been a lot of talk about how people in the need of care can sort of be more independent and take care of themselves. How can we rehabilitate them to sort of take care of their own situation more? And I think that policy has sort of been implemented by now, so it's not discussed to the same extent anymore.
And if you have an opportunity to introduce one new long-term care policy in your country, what would it be and why?
Well, I think in Denmark, we have a problem with the healthcare sector being organised by the regions and the care sector being organised by the municipalities. And I think these two sectors do not always perhaps communicate very well. And I think it could quite easily, although I don't have a ready-made solution, I think it could quite easily improve the communication and the exchange between these two sectors to sort of, optimise resources.
In terms of research priorities, what is it that you think is an outstanding piece of research on long-term care that needs to be carried out in Denmark?
I could mention like a project that I'm working on at present that I think is quite important, although perhaps not outstanding. So what we're trying to do in the present project is to try to figure out what sort of demand and willingness to pay people in the working age population have for their future care. So basically, what do we need? Because I think sometimes people tend to think that older people are so different from younger people, but I think it's quite useful to just think about what you would like for your situation when you get old. And so we're trying to figure out what today's middle-aged people have, what their demands and what their thoughts are on what they will need for their future selves when they get old.
Now I'm going to ask you a few quick questions, and I'm looking for a number in response from 1 to 10, where 1 is low and 10 is high. So what policy priority is allocated to long-term care in Denmark?
6.
How aware is the general public in your country of what long-term care systems offer to them?
6.
And how well does the system support people with long-term care needs?
8.
How well does the system support the need of carers?
Well, if you think about family carers, I would say it's probably around 8 also.
And how integrated are social care and healthcare services in Denmark?
3.
Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for your time.
You.